said it about 100 times, I'ma need it back. Wishing you would come and find me, just to tell me that I haven't changed. Girl, I needed that from you. I'm getting money just taking care of me, girl. I'm spending time just taking care of me right now. I'm getting money just taking care of me, girl. Cause you'll be tired of taking care of me by now.
How you doing? This is Melvin Brown. Welcome back to the Melvin Brown Experience. Today is not going to be a story time. Today is going to be a topic. So listen, what is going to be your game plan of getting your lover back? What is going to be the playbook that's going to win you the goddamn Super Bowl? The Super Bowl meaning as in getting your target back and him being happy. Now, everybody has an idea, like, okay, listen, I'm going to get the spell work done. I'm just going to apologize to them. Yeah, that works, but 9 times out of 10, that don't work. What are you going to change that needed to be changed before this departure happened when you and your lover broke up? Listen, when you get spell work done, you got to have a game plan. It is what it is. You're going to have a plan. Now, listen, if your target left you because you kept on arguing with him, you kept on nagging him, saying some dumb shit, posting him on social media, talking about the dumb shit you doing, and you got another social media account talking about how you want to be hugged and cuddled and shit, and you thirst trapping these other dudes, 9 times out of 10, no man wants to deal with that shit. If you got girlfriends, miserable-ass girlfriends, that can give out the best advice, but somehow she got 7 baby daddies, but none of them in her life, and you take all her advice, you need to kick her to the curb and keep it the fuck moving. Now, let's continue. If you was a woman that felt entitled and belittled your boyfriend all the time, or you always had to take credit. Yeah, I'm the one that bought you this thing. I bought you this car. I got your shit together. Blase, blase. And then you over there, he left me. I really love him. Don't cry. You did that shit to your fucking self. And a relationship is about uplifting. It's not about putting somebody below them and making them feel less of a man or less of a person. You deserve that departure. If you was a woman that wasn't sexually active, and out of nowhere, your target winds up leaving you, and you wasn't that sexually active, then you sit there and regret, like, I should have did this, I should have did that. He said he wanted to do this, he said he wanted to do that. I wasn't interested. But look, y'all in a relationship. If you love that man and that man love you, it's an even exchange sexually. I don't care which, how y'all get down, how dirty it is. It is what it is. Another thing. This is the key that I always hear. All my clients tell me, Melvin, 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 my target is a motherfucking narcissist. Now, listen. If you want to date a narcissist person, the best thing I could tell you to do, read some books, go to therapy, talk to your therapist about it. If it works out, it works out. But let's get to the point where I'm trying to say. In the meantime, while you waiting for your lover to come back, 9 times out of 10, there's already spiritual work on your lover. So if it's a jar, a dial, a candle, it's still energy hitting your target regardless. Now, what will your target feel? They will feel insecurity, paranoia, because they don't know why they feel paranoid. They paranoid about you because they feel like, I fucked up. Then all of a sudden, friends might come along. Yo, why you leave her, yo? Yo, she was a good girl. Damn, she was rocking out. She was doing this, she was doing that. Next thing you know, he's still thinking about you. Out of nowhere, you on Instagram, mind your business, you get a friend request or you get a notification. Oh, GG49989999445 GGBB. Following you on Instagram. Next thing you know, you're like, all right, I don't give a fuck about that. But that person I just said, that little fake ass account there with them all them letters or all them numbers, that more likely that's your target. So I always tell my client this. Even though you're not doing you and having fun, but you is having fun, make it seem like that you're not worried about a damn soul. Because one thing about men, we like to see girls that we leave suffer a little bit. And that was me back in the day. Every girl that left me, I like to see them suffer and go through what they want to go through. The next thing they'll come back to me like, hey, what's up? But we like to see girls suffer. Now, that's people in general. Girls don't like to see men having fun. When they start seeing you having fun, they get intimidated. Nowhere, if you wasn't a girl that knew how to groom herself pretty well, a woman that didn't know how to groom herself, you start grooming yourself, you start looking real good, you start looking real, you got your makeup on, you got all these, you got like 700 likes and shit, more followers, dudes trying to take you out, you taking pictures, or you eating food and shit, or you can have your gay best friend at a club, you and your gay best friend at a club, he got manly arms and muscles. You can tell him, like, yo, take a picture with your arm around me. The whole time, he got his arm around you. He looking at the picture. He's snapping. He like, yo, what the fuck? Yo, we just broke up. Yo. We broke up like 4 months ago, and she out here doing her. Damn, yo, I need a drink. Then he might be over there calling, crying to his friends, like, yo, I did fuck up. And the whole time, he's still thinking about you. So that's the executing plan. So when he call you, he's going to try to get power over you. Oh, what you doing? Yo, I just wanted to talk to you, see how you was doing. Now, rule number, another key. You don't tolerate nothing. You just say, all right, cool. Play it cool. Keep it moving. But he get disrespectful, hang it up. Mind you, at the end of the day, you got to make it seem like he needs you. You don't need him. So he going to be in his feelings. That's the honest truth. Another thing I tell my clients to do, post pictures on your Instagram. Do it on Instagram stories. Post pictures. You post pictures on Instagram stories and you let that shit sit there for a few hours or all day and you view your whoever watch your story. You see whoever view it. He the first person to view it. He the first person online. He was the first person to view it. If he view it, take advantage of the opportunity. Now, I always tell my clients this. What you gotta do, you gotta do this. All right, since he's under a spell, he already paranoid, he already scared, he already yearning for you. What you gotta do? Go on the gram. That's what I say. Go on the fucking gram. Post a picture you wearing lingerie. Go to the dollar store, buy you some candles and shit. Buy some candles, look real good, and just put a little post, like a little subtitle tweet, like. Or not tweet, like a little subtitle typing thing. You just say, yo, tonight gonna be fun. And you just sitting there with your lingerie the whole time. You about to go to sleep with your lingerie with no other man, no nothing. But the whole time, this nigga thinking that you fucking somebody else. Nowhere, he might be posted up. And next thing you know, he might knock on the door. Now, listen, he might call you the next day saying some smart shit like, oh, who you fucking? Play it cool. Now, when he start getting out of line, screaming and yelling, talking about how he hates you and everything, you gotta say, yo, you broke up with me. Why are you acting like this? What's wrong with you? Make it basically reverse psychology on him. Turn the tables on him like, yo, you crazy and everything. Like, what's wrong with you crazy? Yo, and the whole time he probably sitting like, yo, I'm not crazy. Psychopath Steve breathing and shit like, yo, I'm not crazy. Yo, you fucking with me. That's what people say when men under spells, they probably say some shit like that. Yo, you fuck with me. Something ain't right because his mind is racing. He don't know what's going on. Nowhere, he calmed down. Another strategy you should do. Read The Art of Seduction. I have one of my clients. She's a successful woman. She read The Art of Seduction. She didn't read it. She went on YouTube and listened to the 9-hour video and had a whole goddamn journal and wrote everything how she wanted to make a plan. She used that game plan, took advantage of it, and got every bit of the results that she needed to get. Basically, the target came back crying. I mean, he already came back crying, but he... To this point, the target don't want to leave her. The target respect her now. The goal is about getting your power back, woman. It's about getting your power back. When men break up with you, it's about getting your power back. If you was that one woman that always got walked over, not appreciated, taken advantage of, you turn that table around and you use it on him. He gonna respect you more. He gonna cherish you. Next thing you know, another strategy, don't text him as much. When you text him, give him like 6-hour text. It's like, oh, what's up? Oh, I forgot all about you. Oh, what's up? And he already gonna be thirsty, because the moment you start taking 5 steps back, he's gonna take 20 steps ahead of you trying to be where you at. But the whole time, you are in control. Wax on, wax off. It's simple. So while you doing this stuff, his feelings, the spell is already on him. It's latched onto him. His feelings and his mind's already latched onto it. So it's just going to intensify his feelings. So out of nowhere, give him the 60-day rule. That's the next strategy. Give him 60 days not to have sex with you. And next thing you know, he pay attention. He not going to break the rules. He going to appreciate you more. I think I said this before in the meantime. I'm going to say it again. Buy some self-help books. Self-help books. That is the key. I have plenty of clients that buy self-help books or go on YouTube and listen to self-help audiobooks. That's going to be the key. Because during this time of y'all separation, it's about rebuilding you and making yourself a new person. That's why some of my clients, they get so happy. They don't even want their target back no more. They go elsewhere because the self-help books must have helped them. They seen the truth and find something else. Let's continue. Another thing, what you should do. Now, sex do play a key role in a relationship. What you should do, you should spice it up. For example, it's this woman, go by the name of Erotica Angel, or Angel Erotica. And I'm going to have her picture again on here again. This woman made my client's target satisfied with the technique she got and everything, to the point that it is what it is. Read books like that, you learn things. That's the key. And once you put your target through all that stuff, when you have sex with them, soon you have sex with them, play it off like, all right, it was cool and everything, but I got things to do, y'all. I got things to do. And the whole time, he might sit there, yo, why is she kicking me out the house? What's going on? And then out of nowhere, he gonna start showing you more. Because one thing about love is not just a verbal type of thing. Love is an action word. This person wind up, even with the spell work and everything I told you to do, winds up showing you, giving you action, giving you his word, doing everything he can for you. Then out of nowhere, y'all together, then you can give them the key to your house. Then you can do what you got to do. That's what I mean. This strategy depends on yourself. Now, since y'all got this, I want y'all to leave a comment, email me, hit the like button. You can subscribe. But I hope this strategy was great for y'all. This is Melvin Brown. This is the Melvin Brown Experience. I'm out.